Hello again from your friends at Right Auto. We got a 2011 Ford Super Duty F-350 1-ton. This is a full crew cab, four-door, long bed, four-wheel drive with the FX4 off-road package. It's got the 6.7-liter Power Stroke turbo diesel trailer tow package. It's got all sorts of toolboxes and bed racks and bed rails in here. We'll get close up and show you. It's got the alloy wheels, the running boards, the telescopic towing mirrors, tow hooks on the front, engine block heater. There is no hail on the vehicle. I know it just started raining on us, but we're determined to do this video for you. It's got the off-road shocks. Look at the frame on this thing, clean. The condition of the tires are really nice. New batteries. This vehicle was recently serviced at Ford. So this thing's on the up and up, ready to go, fresh oil change. Take a look at the interior. Plain Jane, and some people like it like that. Good old work truck. That's what it is with the 60/40 seating. That comes down. No check engine, no airbag, not even a low tire light on. Auxiliary switches, vinyl floor, shift on the flat four-wheel drive. Just had the vehicle detailed. Under the doors, the cab corners on the rockers on this vehicle are in good shape. Back seat's in nice shape. You got a auxiliary fuel tank with the switch inside. You got the bed rack. You got a steel plate here with the fifth wheel gooseneck hitch. Locking rear differentials. Sharp looking truck, folks. You're looking at it. Look at the frame on this thing. Clean. Out of state vehicle. Here's the other side of the vehicle. Let's take you on a short test drive. I'll show you how the vehicle drives. These running boards makes it easy to get into the vehicle once you're into the vehicle. You got your basic options. Exact miles of the vehicle, 205-691, no check, no misfire, no hesitation. Now, we got a locking rear differential. All you gotta do is put that in the on position. You lock the rear end and there's an indicator there, and then you wanna put it in four high, you just pull that back, there's a light there. So both of those are functional. We're actually gonna replace this radio with the aftermarket one because the LEDs on this one has gone bad. That's a common issue with these. So we're gonna have a nicer radio with the Bluetooth and the iPod connection, and it'll be installed probably when you come look at the vehicle. This one's got the 60/40 seating with the center console and nice deep storage here. Automatic transmission goes from gear to gear without any delays or hard kicks. You could also change the transmission manually on this one. It's a 6-speed, there's a plus and a minus there. So it is base, but it's not that base. There's your automatic climate control. Now, in our inventory, you're going to find all sorts of trucks. The 6.0s, the 7.3, the 6.7. So, Ford is a top seller for us, and we like them. And this particular truck, let's see if we can negotiate this turn here. How are we doing on that side?
Doing good.
Okay.
Yeah, you're good.
The heat is starting to come on. The AC does work as well. Let's wear a seatbelt here and take you on a short test drive. And one of the reasons we do these videos for you guys is not because we enjoy doing it, but because we take pride and we want to make sure that the customers that come see us, we just had some folks that picked up a vehicle from us. They drove, believe it or not, 5 hours to get to us. And based on the video that we provided to them, similar vehicle videos you're watching right now, is we're honest with what we see. So if we see any imperfection on the vehicle, we point it out to you. Here we are right now. The automatic transmission shifts nice. Vehicle drives straight, handles the bumps really well. Being a 1-ton, now naturally this thing is going to be really bumpy because it is a 1-ton, but it's actually a pretty smooth ride. I'm impressed with it. I think Ford's on a fantastic job with this newer body style that they came up with in 2011. And when they came up with this 6.7 engine, this thing had class leading torque and power, just like they do right now with the 2020. Now they have 1,000 torque. Back then they had about, I believe, 650 torque. So right now this truck has about it's got about a 350 horse, and more importantly, close to 700 foot-pounds of torque. So if you're going to want to tow and pull, this would be the right truck to do it. And if you're thinking, you know what, this one doesn't have all the bells and whistles, just keep in mind window regulators, door lock actuators, when they go bad, it could cost you a lot of money. And it's not bad to reach over every once in a while to stretch your legs and your arms to, you know, to do the manual window. You might consider it an exercise. So give us a call with any other questions you have on this vehicle, and we'll be happy to help you. Thank you.